Now we're heading over to the bustling city of Beijing, China. With the rapid growth and subsequent pollution that China has experienced in the past decade, climate change activists in the East are lucky to have an advocate with the passion of our next presenter. She is the founder of Impact, a Chinese enterprise dedicated to promoting sustainable ways of living. Live from Beijing, please welcome Anne Wang.
Here's how it works. As heat trapping CO2 increases, so does the temperature. And as temperature increases, more water is evaporated from the ocean into the sky. That's when the droughts become deeper and longer. This summer in China, we saw the highest temperature record since we ever started using the thermometer a century and a half ago.
Please welcome ecologist and staff scientist at Climate Central, Nicole Heller, executive director for the Human Impacts Institute, Tara DePorte, from the College of Earth and Mineral Sciences at Penn State, Dean Bill Easterling, and from the University of South Carolina's Environment and Sustainability Program, Professor Brian Helmuth.
One of the more robust findings that years of research have given us in understanding the climate system is that as the planet warms, there will be more evaporation of water. This is just a simple physical law. And this will translate into more precipitation across the planet, but very importantly, it will also result in higher intensity rainfall events.
As a biologist, there's been a lot of work to look at how are the plant and animal communities responding, and we see them flowering earlier in the year.
Right.
We see them moving and tracking the climate to stay with where it's so all the signs from our backyards to this global picture are saying the same thing.
It's important to kind of keep in mind that science works not by trying to prove something is right, but we try to prove ideas are wrong. So we've known for over 150 years that increases in carbon dioxide or the greenhouse gases lead to increases in the Earth's temperature. But also that doesn't mean we can dismiss other ideas like volcanoes and changes in solar activity. Mm-hmm. But firsthand, despite decades and decades of study, no one has been able to disprove that increases in greenhouse gases have led to the increase in temperature.
I think what we're seeing here is a breakdown of communication between scientists, between media, between educators and the general public, where we have different languages. As a scientist, you don't speak in certainties. We don't say, I'm 100% sure. In media, there's never one side to a story. So we're having this issue where, therefore, the story is not being told the same as the science we're seeing.
What we have now, and this is very important, is that we have an almost even race between the growth in world demand for food and the ability to grow the food supply. And where we used to have excess capacity, it's not there today.
Right.
And so any disruptions, and we're seeing it across the globe, and prices are immediately affected. And I don't see this getting any better anytime soon, and climate change becomes really problematic.
We have to support policy change here in the United States and in other countries. I think there's a lot of grassroots activism to change that, because what we really need in many ways is a signal from the national government that we're serious about mitigating carbon, and we're going to put a price on it. And when that starts to happen, I think the business sector will respond. I think that they will innovate, because that's what we do best.
We'll be right back.